If you've been watching some of my other videos, you know I've been building a terrarium. And in that terrarium, I've got a pond. In that pond, I've got some lights. Now these lights that I installed are these. These are very simple 12-volt direct current LEDs that are made to run on a boat or a motorcycle taillight, that type of thing. Super cheap, I got them from AliExpress. I think they're maybe a couple of dollars, a couple of euros for a package of five of them. But the problem is they just come really simple. Just a wire and the light, that's it. And they're made to connect to 12 volts DC. And they work. They turn on and they emit light. But the problem is they're always the same brightness. And what I wanted to do in my pond was to have the lights come on a little bit slowly, kind of like a sunrise. Otherwise it boom comes on and shocks the frogs and you don't want to give your frogs a frog heart attack. So how can we make these bright and dim? Unlike incandescent lights, these guys actually flicker, maybe 120 times per second. And that flickering controls the overall brightness. Think about it like a strobe light. If you flash a light like this, you're gonna see it flash. But if you flash it like this, eventually it flashes so fast, it seems like the lights are on all the time, and it seems like it's really bright. The trick is, how can we make the time that the light is on a little bit longer than when it is off? You wouldn't see this, but effectively, if you make the time that is on longer than the time it is off, it will be brighter, and the opposite. If you make the time that it is on shorter than the time that it is off, it'll effectively appear dimmer. So how do we do this? A phase width modulator, PWM. Well, that's what this guy is. This is a Nicrew phase width modulator. They're made to go with different brands, but the basic idea is the same. It simply shortens or lengthens the width of the phases. If we string this guy in between the power source and the light, we can effectively shorten and lengthen the time that is on versus the time that is off and brighten and dim the lights. So let's try to see if it works. So now we've got all the things connected together and we're sure it all works. The light works, the power source works, and the timer works. Everything's connected together correctly. Now it's time to actually set this timer. Now one of the things about these timers that I mentioned before is that when they lose power, even though they don't lose the programming, they lose the time of day. Now, at first glance, that seems like that would be a real dumb thing to do. Why not just put a battery in there? But in fact, this is very smart, because if you know that when you power this on, it's always gonna start at midnight, ultimately you could control the power in using something like a smart outlet, which you can then control from a smartphone, and ultimately then control when the whole cycle begins and ends. We just need to program it to give us the cycles and the times and the dimming that we want at the times that we want. Now it comes with an instruction manual, but that instruction manual is not the easiest to pour through. So after going through a bunch of YouTube videos, seeing what other people did, and tinkering around with it myself, I figured out something that works, and I'll try to explain what I did. This timer comes with three different functions or modes. F1 means the light goes from off to on like a light switch. F2 goes from off to on over the period of 30 minutes. F3 goes from off to on in 15 minutes. For each one of these modes, you can set up to 6 different levels. Each one of those levels has two things associated with it, the time of day and the brightness. Say at 6 a.m. we want the lights to come on. Then at the end of the day, at 10 p.m., we want them to go off. That's 16 hours difference. And say we want it to get slowly brighter to about 7 o'clock in the morning until that's full brightness, and that's gonna continue all the way to the end of the day because I like to look at the tank during the day and I don't wanna have it dim late in the day. So we're gonna have a big block of bright light in the middle. So that's our plan, that's what we want. So when our IKEA timer goes off at 6 a.m., that's gonna turn this one on. When this one comes on, it's gonna think it's actually midnight. So whatever setting we set for this, for 6 a.m., we want to set it for midnight. And same with 7 o'clock, That's 1 hour after midnight, which is 1 o'clock. 9 o'clock is 15 hours after midnight, or 3 o'clock. And 10 o'clock is 16 hours after midnight, or 4 o'clock. These don't really matter all that much. It's just in relation to when this thing starts. Now, what levels do we want to set at? Remember, when the lights come on, it's starting at zero. And since we're using this mode of F3, it takes 15 minutes for it to ramp towards a goal. So, say at 6 a.m., if we set it to 50%, that means by 6:15, it will achieve 50% brightness. At 7 o'clock, we want to shoot for, say, 100%. That means by 7:15, it will reach 100%. Same thing when the sun goes down. When it's 3 o'clock, internally, let's shoot for 50% brightness, so that by 9:15, it will be 50% brightness. And by 10, we want to shoot towards 0%. We want to turn off the lights. So by 10:15, the lights will be at 0%. So these settings here are what you need to program into this to give it the cycle that we want. And we program these in level 1, level 2, level 3, and level 4. And those are saved in this, so even if the power goes off, when it starts this cycle. This means the IKEA switch can be used to control this, start it from anywhere in the world. When the lights come on, it'll take 15 minutes to get to 50% and go all through this cycle. Okay, let's see if we can walk through this. Press here to go into programming mode for 3 seconds. We're in programming mode. Now, we're in F3 mode, okay. Level 1, fine. Starting at midnight, okay. At 50%, that's what we want. Level 2, that's starting at 1 o'clock, okay. That's at 100%, fine. Level 3, we want that to start at 1500, fine. And that's at 50%. And the last level is level 4 at 1600. We want that to go to 0. So we've got the timer programmed correctly, and now we just need to hook it up into the system and see if it works. One of the great things about these timers is they come with an extra set of adapters. So that means we can put some connectors into our line and be able to remove the timer whenever we want to, program it, or even replace it if we want. And if it doesn't work the way we want, we can take it out of the line and we don't have to do more soldering. So now the lights are on, they're about 10-15%, something like that, because in fact, it's now about noon and I just started the timer, which means it's a bit out of cycle. So the next time it will start at 6 a.m., which starts at 0 for the timer, and it'll start the cycle correctly. So it works.